So we've been compacting a whole lot of learning into a very short time frame. So we're going to show you some of the things that we do every day. This first piece that we're starting off with, Non Nobis Domine, is a round. We do a lot of those in class. We use them for being able to hang on to your part, singing different parts at the same time, and yet we all learn the same part. So we're going to start off with a little bit of In the Round of Non Nobis.
Oh.
So one of the things that we do in class is that we have to learn the music. But we don't do something called rote learning, which is, hey, Mr. B, play me something short that I can actually repeat back. Da, 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 da. We don't do that, okay? That's true, okay? Instead, what we're doing is we learn how to actually read the music, where you pick up the piece of paper, read the notes, and translate that ink that's on the page into music and into singing. It's learning a totally different language that is very different from what we normally do. But the tool that we use to do that is solfege. They do hand signs and solfege, and they're going to show you a little bit of what that looks like.
Yeah.
Okay. Two, and one, two, three.
Do, so, 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 so,
so, so, so, so, so, so, so, so, so, so, so, so, so, so, so, do it. So we're
going to
do it one more time and
you're going to
show that too.
Yeah.
Okay,
there.
One, two, three. When they see the dots on the page, that's what they pull out of it. And those symbols, those hand signs, and those solfege sounds represent pitches to them. They're not like a piano. I want Mr. Benches to play a C. He pushes the button and the note comes out. It's really exciting. But if you guys can sing F sharp, please. Ready, go. Yeah, singing doesn't work that way. Everything is relative to us. So the solfege gives us an anchor to hold on to. We're going to move on, though. Our next piece is a little bit not as happy as the last one was. It's called Roses I Sent to You, and we've been discussing what it is about, but let's see if you can get the meaning of the song the way they convey it to you.
Jesus, you see.
last piece is called See a Hummer. And it's a South African freedom song. And the way that these songs were used in was during the apartheid movement, that there was a group of people who were treated as lower class citizens, and a group of people who were a much smaller group treated as upper class citizens. And the lower class ones decided they were tired of that. And so what they did is they began to march through the streets saying that we would like to be treated equally, we would like to be treated the same. You may have heard of a guy, Nelson Mandela, possibly.
Yeah.
That's from this time period. And what they would do is they would go out in the streets and they would march and they would walk and they would sing for days and days and days on end. And these songs are what kept them going, what kept them driving, kept them moving forward. So we've got a little bit of movement that we've put in this. We've talked about what the feeling is that goes along with this song. So this is our version of See a Hummer.
See ya, humpe, cuca, nieni, cuecos. See ya, humpe, cuca, nieni, cuecos. See ya, humpe, cuca, nieni, cuecos. See ya, humpe, cuca, nieni, cuecos.
We're going to show you what we do every day. We're going to do a little bit of a warm-up for you, okay? D major, Mr. Gretchen. I brought my friend here. Will you say hello?
Hello.
Oh, come on. Say
hello.
Hello.
I have a big poodle.
The things you do to teach me.
Hello, my little pink poodle.
Hello, my little pink poodle.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, come on, give me a
hi.
Oh.
talking about that each group has a thing. Well, this is Magicals, and they have a thing. They sing 300-year-old music out in the middle of the woods. At least that's what we did last weekend when we went to a Renaissance fair out at Stronghold in Oregon, Illinois. What this group focuses on is music from the mid-1500s. This is music that is 4 to 6 parts. Let's see, what else? Most of the music is programmatic in that the music actually tells a story and the music is descriptive of what you hear. The first piece that they're going to do for you is, they might not know, 4 arms, 2 necks, 1 reading. So I would love to see you again, but unfortunately, I'm getting married today.